Hello, this is Hugo. I'm going to demonstrate the use of Kicad for spice simulation. First of all, this is not the stable build. This is a nightly build, and I'll show you which version it is. You can see the version number here. It's 4.8.053. Now, let's start a new project. And I'll name it High Pass. Okay, I'll start the schematic editor. And we need some components. There are two libraries especially I'm using for spice. This is the device library, which is included in the standard installation. And the capacitor, which I'll rotate with R. And I also need a resistor, and I like the European symbols. Then I also need something else. It's a voltage source, and I'm going to take this out of the spice basic library. I will include a link to this extra library. V is a generic source, a voltage source, of course, and now I'll add the nets or wires to the schematic. Of course, you need a ground reference. Now we'll add values to the components, and we do that by pressing V, value, and replacing the text by a value, for instance, this one. Also pressing V, and I'll change this to 50k. I'm using, of course, regular spice notation conventions. The voltage source will be used for an AC analysis. So, a good idea to change this to AC1. Now, to give the components their final names, I'll use this shortcut, annotate schematic symbols, and you will see I now have a C1, an R1, and a V1. Now we can start simulating. We'll go to the tools, simulator, references, not but settings. I want 20 points for each decade. I'm going from 100 to 1 meg. Start the simulation. Simulation is done, and now I will add the plots I need by pressing probe. This is our output. And now I'll go back to the simulator, and you see I have a phase characteristic. The green one goes from about 90 degrees and to zero, and for infinity it should become zero. And we also have the magnitude characteristic in red. Nice feature is also the tune one, the tune feature. If you press tune and you go, for instance, to R, and then you go back to the simulator, you get an extra here. I can change the value of R1 with this slider, and the simulation is repeated immediately each time I change the value of R1. It's rather nice. You can also save your work as an image. Unfortunately, only in bitmaps at this moment. Or as comma separated values. That's it. Hope you liked it.